Bobby said we all want to win. There's no doubt about it. We want to be competitive. We want to give our best. But we need to keep all this in perspective as we go about our business. It's okay if we lose. It's not okay if we lose if we don't give our best effort. So what I'm going to try to do is send or share something with 11U, 12U, 13U, 14U that I probably didn't get advice from my dad until I was 17, 18, and 19 years old. Take care of yourself, and everything else will take care of itself. Okay, when I went away to play professional ball my first year, Dad told me that. I didn't quite understand what it meant. Then I played 5 years with the Orioles. I got released by the Orioles. I go to Texas as a non-rostered invitee. I'm in a dugout fighting for a utility job. There's two other guys fighting for that one spot with me, 3-for-1. I'm sitting in the dugout. I'm next to a guy that's fighting for the position. There's a guy at home plate fighting for that position. That guy struck out. The guy next to me went, yeah. So what did you say yeah for? Because he struck out. I said, I understand he struck out. So the more I sat next to this guy, the more I thought, well, wait a minute. When I'm up at home plate, he's rooting against me. Now let's think about that for a minute. Take care of yourself. And things will have a way of taking care of themselves. Even if I would have failed, the guy at home plate failed. And the guy next to me ends up getting the job because of our two failures, ultimately he's going to end up failing. Because he didn't do it on his own merits, he didn't do it succeeding and worrying about himself, he was worried about other players. In your baseball career, guys, you will see people bigger, faster, stronger than you are. No ifs, ands, and buts about it. But if you take care of yourself, in most cases, you're good enough will be good enough. I said in most cases, because there will be a point in time when the baseball world will stop for us. That's just reality. But that doesn't mean that we have to go outside of our own thought process and our own efforts on how to succeed. This is not only good advice on the baseball field, this is what we should do when we go about our business in life. When we're in school, I'm not worried about what the person next to me does. If he gets a laugh, and you know that that ultimately is going to get you in trouble, let's not do that. Let's worry about ourselves, not what other people do. If you worry about yourself, things will have a way of working themselves out. One last thing I'd like to talk about, and this probably goes for some of the older kids here with 14 U's. You never know who's going to be watching. Now, 11-year-olds, don't forget this. 14 U's. The college world starts real soon for these kids, don't they, parents? Colleges are starting to look at us. We're trying to get in front of these people. We built this place to try to provide an opportunity and an experience for these kids. We didn't build this place to breed big league baseball players. If that happens, great. Congratulations. We'd love to see it happen. But what we did is we provided an opportunity for these kids to play the game, to get in front of some people, to experience some things in life that they normally wouldn't be able to do. We put a lot of effort in building these fields. These fields are probably, I hope, better than any other field you play on this year. We knew what it was like, myself and Cal, to walk out into Yankee Stadium and go, wow. We knew what it was like to play in Fenway Park. Wow. We also know that the percentage of people that play this game of baseball, between my little fingers right here, is what will understand what it's like to play in Yankee Stadium or Fenway. But if we can provide something as nice as this, we can provide it in a location where it's a vacation destination, we can have a great week of baseball, and more importantly, more so for the 11-year-olds, 12-year-olds, after we leave the baseball field, then we did our job here. So when I say, be careful of what you do on a baseball field because you never know what or who is watching. We can go 0-for-4. We can still turn heads of a college recruiter. We can still turn heads of a college coach if we handle ourselves on the field properly. If I go 0-for-4 at the dish and I turn a double play, 6-4-3 to end the game, that's putting a check in my book if I'm a college coach looking for a player. He didn't let the offense affect his defense. For the 11 and 12-year-olds, right, wrong, or indifferent, there are coaches of other 11 and 12-year-old teams that look for talent to go to another tournament destination. There are also coaches on those fields and on those teams that might see a kid that has a little bit of talent and a bad attitude. And that bad attitude might have been received from one of those people out there. And then in this opportunity or experience that might be around the corner for your child, that coach might say, I don't know if I want to deal with that. That kid was good, but did you see the actions of that parent? So kids, you never know who's watching. Parents, you never know who's watching. I want to compete, I want to win. But this tournament destination is to go out there and give your best, learn, improve, and have a great experience in life. If we win the championship of the entire planet, yeah, I'll give you a thumbs up for it. But that's not the biggest and best thing, what we want to do. Thank you for your time today.